Hello students, welcome to the class. And in this class I will not be dealing with the lead editorial, rather I will be dealing with the ethical debate, the debate of ethics behind active euthanasia and passive euthanasia. Now this is very important topic for your mains examination and especially for 2018 mains. So first of all we will be understanding what is euthanasia. And along with this euthanasia, we will be also understanding the living will. And we will be also understanding the ethics lying behind passive euthanasia and active euthanasia. And why this passive euthanasia has been brought into practice in India. Now first of all, we need to understand the concept and the purpose of the life. Now man is born free on this planet called Earth. But when man is born on this planet Earth, he is actually born in a milieu, in an environment. And what is this environment? The man is born in a particular family, the man is born in a particular country, a man is born in a particular state. So when a man is born on this planet, he actually loses his free will. There is a kind of a tacit agreement between him and the family. There is a kind of agreement between him and his parents, between him and the society, between him and the country. So there is a kind of this a social agreement, but with respect to the state, he has a social contract. So the man actually loses his freedom. He actually gives away a part of his freedom so that he can make the society livable. So this is the concept of man. Now, because man is born free, he has certain rights. He has been conferred certain fundamental rights by which he can actually unleash himself, by which he can actually utilize his potential. Uske beech mein jitna bhi potential hai, usko use karne ke liye, ek result nikalne ke liye, ek productivity, ek output nikalne ke liye, उसको बहुत सारा फ्रीडम दे दिया गया, फंडामेंटल राइट्स दे दिए गए. ऑन द अदर हैंड सर्टन राइट्स हैव बीन टेकन अवे फ्रॉम हिम ताकि सोसाइटी को हम अच्छी तरह से चला सके, मॉनिटर कर सके, सोसाइटी में एनोमिक फीचर ना आए, सोसाइटी में डिसरप्शन ना आए, सोसाइटी में कोई भी प्रॉब्लम ना आए, सोसाइटी में ऐसा ना हो कि एक आदमी दूसरे आदमी का राइट छीन ले. So that is the reason certain fundamental rights have been conferred on the man so that he can realize his potential. On the other hand, certain rights have been taken away from him so that the society can become a livable place. But a very important thing here is those rights which doesn't endanger the peace of society should not be taken away from an individual. And the very important right that we are discussing here is right to life. Now, a man, because he is born free, he should also have the right to live the way he actually wants to live. And living also means he should also have the right not to cause the pain to his body. He should have the right to avoid that pain. He should have the right not to be inflicted with any kind of injury or danger. But because this man, it is having a life which is not infinite. The life is actually having a certain time span. And that is the reason that human beings, they get inflicted with the numerous diseases and the life becomes miserable. They are in a lot of pain and they just want to get out of this pain. They just wanted to get out of this sorry state of affairs that they actually are in. Itni buri halat mein koi bhi rehna nahi pasand karega. वो उस हालात से निकलना पसंद करेगा. बिकॉज यू नो that you are just prolonging your pain just by taking the medicines, just by taking the life support system, or just by using the advances of the science and technology in the medical domain. You are just prolonging your pain. You will not be able to get out of it. We have numerous diseases in which the person falls in a vegetative state, or the brain actually dies. So in such a situation, it is important for a person, for a man, to actually seize that pain. Us dard ko wo rok le, us dard ko wo khatam kar de. Aur dard ko khatam kar raha kaise ja sakta hai agar wo apni life ko khatam kar de. It is like taking away the life, taking away one's own life. And that is very important thing. Taking away one's own life. But with respect to India, when you are in pain, or when your health condition is such that you are not living a good life, a dignified life, in that case you want to take away your life. Now suppose you have been hospitalized for a particular condition, for a dreaded condition, and you know that you will not be able to come out of it. You want that a life support system should be withdrawn, because that life support system that has been given to you in the on the hospital bed, it is actually prolonging your, you're lying on a hospital bed, it is just prolonging your pain. Now when you want that this support system should be taken away, this is known as passive euthanasia. This is something that has recently been allowed by Supreme Court in common cause NGO case. Now this common cause NGO case was filed in the court, and the Supreme Court has finally given a verdict on it. This case had prolonged for 20 years, but very important judgment has come from the Supreme Court, in which it had said that right to life also includes the right to die in a dignified manner. So earlier what we had talked in the beginning of this class was the concept of the man living freely, and we have also talked about the concept of how there is a kind of contract and how he should be enjoying his fundamental rights, and one of the core fundamental rights is right to life. So in the right to life, he should also have the right to give away his life in a dignified manner, and for this passive euthanasia is something that has been allowed. And बहुत सारे लोग जो इस तरह की बीमारियों से ग्रसित हो जाते हैं वो अपना एक लिविंग विल भी छोड़ सकते हैं. अगेन दिस हैज बीन अलाउड बाय द सुप्रीम कोर्ट. अगर आपको लगता है कि कभी जिंदगी में आप ऐसा इस तरह का कोई एक्सीडेंट हो जाएगा, आपको कुछ न्यूरोलॉजिकल डिसऑर्डर हो जाएगा, आपको मल्टीपल स्क्लेरोसिस हो जाएगा, कुछ इस तरह को कोई भी बीमारी हो जाएगा, उस सिचुएशन में आप अपना एक लिविंग विल छोड़ सकते हो कि आपका जीने, आप अपने दर्द को लंबा नहीं खींचना चाहते. एंड व्हाट यू वांट इज पैसिव यूथनेशिया. नाउ पैसिव यूथनेशिया इज नॉट टेकिंग अवे द लाइफ, इट इज नॉट किलिंग समबडी. पैसिव यूथनेशिया इज व्हाट इट इज नॉट किलिंग. बट व्हाट इट इज पैसिव यूथनेशिया इज letting one die, letting one die, and it is killing. दो चीजें हैं हमारे पास पैसिव यूथनेशिया. ये नहीं है कि उसको मार दिया जाए, बट उसका मतलब क्या, letting one die, उसको बचाने का कोशिश नहीं किया जा रहा. और एक्टिव यूथनेशिया में उसको मारा जा रहा है, यहां मारा नहीं जा रहा, उसको बचाने का कोशिश नहीं किया जा रहा, उसको मरने दिया जा रहा है. पता है कि आप सपोर्ट सिस्टम विड्रॉ कर लोगे वो मर जाएगा. किलिंग में तो आप डायरेक्टली उसको मार दोगे. नाउ बिकॉज वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम एथिक्स परस्पेक्टिव, सो वी हैव टू एथिक्स हियर दैट इज अंडरलाइंग दिस एंटायर डिबेट ऑफ पैसिव एंड एक्टिव यूथनेशिया. द फर्स्ट थिंग इज अबाउट द एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया. अब एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया बहुत बुरा है, इट इज अनएथिकल, इट इज ग्रेव. और इट इज द पैसिव यूथेनेशिया दैट इज अनएथिकल और इट इज मोर ग्रेव और इट इज मोर ईवल. ना आउट ऑफ किलिंग जस्ट एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया, आपने इंजेक्शन दे दिया जहर का, उसको मार दिया, एकदम से वो मर जाएगा एक घंटे में दो घंटे में. दूसरा आपने लाइफ सपोर्ट सिस्टम विड्रॉ कर लिया है, एक हफ्ता लगेगा उसको, शायद डेढ़ हफ्ता लगेगा, फिर वो मर जाएगा. नाउ यहां पे क्या डिफरेंस, क्या व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस हियर? इन एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया यू आर कटिंग द पेन देयर एंड देन, बहुत जल्दी आप उस पेन को खत्म कर रहे हो. यहां पे आप पेन को प्रोलोंग कर रहे हो, यू आर प्रोलोंगिंग द पेन. नाउ दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अल्टीमेटली यूथेनेशिया क्यों डिस्कस करते हैं हम? डिग्निफाइड लाइफ जीने के लिए. जब आपको पता है कि आदमी डिग्निफाइड लाइफ नहीं जी पाएगा तो उसका लाइफ सपोर्ट सिस्टम आप विड्रॉ कर ले हो. तो आप उसकी पेन को ना तो आप उसका इलाज कर रहे हो, ना आप उसको बचाने का कोशिश करते हो. तो जितने दिन भी वो जिएगा बहुत दर्दनाक हालात में जिएगा वो. तो ये पैसिव यूथेनेशिया से व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इज टू गिव अ डिग्निफाइड डेथ टू समवन. इट इज एक्चुअली नॉट गेटिंग एग्जिबिटेड. इसे लगता नहीं है कि उसको एक अच्छा मौत मिल पाएगा जिसमें उसको दर्द नहीं होगा. जो एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया है, अगर दोनों का हम देखें एट द फेस, हमें क्या लगता है कि एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया तो बहुत ईवल है, तो एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया तो कभी अलाउ नहीं करना चाहिए. बट देयर इज अ वेरी फाइन डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया एंड पैसिव यूथेनेशिया. एंड बट व्हेन वी डेल्व डीप इन द डिबेट ऑफ दिस एक्टिव एंड पैसिव, वी फाइंड दैट एक्टिव यूथेनेशिया इट इज फार मोर लेस evil in comparison to passive euthanasia. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS, and you can also place order on brainyias.com, and you can also join our offline and online classes in Delhi and in Chandigarh, and you can also install our application. Name of the application is IAS Buzz. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.